ஆழ்வார்சேஸ் பாதமடைவதன் பாசத்தாலே மற்றவன் பாசங்கள் முற்றவிட்டு கோதில் புகழ்குருகு தன்னடி. பாதமடைவதன் பாசத்தாலே அவர் பாசம் அஃபெக்ஷன் மஸ்ட் ஒன்லி பி டுவர்ட்ஸ் த லோட்டஸ் ஃபீட் ஆஃப் பகவான். பாதமடைவதன் பாசத்தாலே மற்றவன் பாசங்கள் முற்றவிட்டு பாசம் டுவர்ட்ஸ் கிருஷ்ணா லவ் டுவர்ட்ஸ் கிருஷ்ணா அண்ட் ஒன் பாசம் மஸ்ட் பி ரிலீஸ்ட் நாட் டுவர்ட்ஸ் திஸ் மெட்டீரியல் வேர்ல்ட். ஐ காட் டு நோ ஃப்ரம் கபோதா. தென் த நைன்த் ஒன் அஜதரஹா. அஜதரஹா த பைத்தன் இஸ் த குவாலிட்டி ஆஃப் அ பைத்தன். இட் இல் லை டவுன், இட் இல் லை டவுன், இட் இல் வெயிட் வெயிட் அண்ட் வெயிட். இட் இல் நாட் கோ இன் சர்ச் ஆஃப் எனி ஃபுட். It will just wait for its food to come by its side. When it comes, it will just make one moment to grab, eat, lie, wait again. Similarly, a prapanna, a one who has absolutely surrendered to Krishna, must wait for Krishna to bless. Don't jump. You don't go in search of anything. He will come and bless you. But when he comes and blesses, yes, that is for spiritual. He never said that. So Swami, don't go to job. Don't take care of your parents because he will come. Wait, when I say that, it's all Bhagavan's blessing. Please plead to Bhagavan, pray to him. That does not mean that. Go to exams without preparation, he will come and write. I never said there is this exam time, there are hundreds and hundreds of students coming doing pradakshina to Hanumar Sanadhi and Chakravarti Sanadhi. 100 times, 1000 times, you ensure that it's enough that you do 4 times or 6 times or 10 times. Not necessarily that you go round and round for 108 or 1008. They also write their examination hall ticket numbers on the walls. Because Hanuman has to come and award marks to you. You must know your number. Expect what is for you. Expect Bhagavan to bless. But don't stop your prayatnam. We have to put in our efforts. And our efforts are just not enough. It has to be His grace too. It is His grace coupled with our efforts which will happen. Now, let me give you an example. I dig a big pond. For what? When it rains, I have to store water. Just on finishing, completing the pond, I requested to rain gods. Now that I have completed digging, can you rain now? It will not. It won't. But I was furious. Since I have completed digging, there were no rains, I decided hereafter, I will not dig anything. You don't. What will happen? When there are rains, you cannot store. So just because you have dug, there won't be rain. But because there are no rains, if you did not dig, you won't store. How will you take a decision now? I don't think am I confusing you a lot? Vanathidara yeriyam vannam yetru viduvallal mari yarpai hippar matru. Alvar says, you can only dig and keep waiting. It is for the rain gods to bless you and rain. When it rains, yes, you are blessed to store. You can only take this stand. If whether it rains or not, you will have to dig. Similarly, I have to put in my efforts and wait for Bhagavan to bless. Just because you have acted, he need not act. But since he is not acting when I want him to act, if you stop, it will be wasted. So you will have to act, wait for his response. He would respond, then accept his responses. This is what I learned from this Ajagara. Then the 10th Acharya, Har Ajagaraha, 10th Sindhu, Sindhu ocean. The ocean, we cannot cross the ocean. We cannot measure the ocean. We cannot churn the ocean. We cannot do anything with the ocean. It is so deep. Ocean nale gambhiryam. Gambhirye samudraiva gambhirye. No one can understand what is happening in a deep ocean. Similarly, a yogi's mind is never understandable. He is so deep in his thoughts that I cannot cross him. I cannot question him. I cannot go past him. I cannot measure him. I can do nothing with a yogi because he is so honest. He is so absorbed in Brahman that he is always a mystery to me. He is good, but he is a mystery to me. I do not know how to go past him. That is how a yogi would behave. Then the 11th one, Patangaha, Patangaha, firefly. What was the mistake of this firefly? There is a lamp that is lit. Did the lamp invite the firefly to come and get killed? It was not. Then why did it come? Because it is so fond of rupam. The fire has a rupam. That glitter, that beautiful flame, when you set something, when you like something, just see whether this liking is right or the liking is limited or is it turning to lust. This is a lust. because you should have thought, because it liked the glitter, it went near. But the glitter is going to be very dangerous for me. It is suicidal. The firefly did not realize it is suicidal because his lust overcame his reasoning. That is where it went wrong. So from a firefly, I understood that don't get carried away by glitter. All that glitters are not gold. I came to know. Then Madhukrut. Honey bee. What does this honey bee do? It collects. It collects, collects and collects. Small drops of honey from every flower possible. But this honey bee has a beautiful system. The system is, it will never hurt any flower. It will never over collect from any flower. The flower will by voluntarily submit honey to the honey bee. Similarly, yogi also must collect for his livelihood. The yogi cannot earn for himself. He has to beg from others. But don't pluck from others. Beg from others. Today you nominate 3-4 houses. Just take few items. Tomorrow you nominate, you keep 3-4 houses. Take a little from them. Day after you nominate 3-4. Take a little from them. Take little but from many. It has to be little but take it from many. Now do you receive donation, say $100,000 from 2-3 people or $100 from 1,000 people? 100 from 1,000 is the system of honeybee. Because they will also be happy. They won't be hurt by what you ask. And for you also, you will have many contributors. That's very important. So I learned this from the honeybee. Then gajaha. Gaja. Elephant. Elephant is carried away by the touch feeling. There are 5 feelings. Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha. Now we talked about firefly, which always get carried away from Rupa. Agni Rupa. Now is the second. An elephant, it is so fond of touching female elephants. The touch feeling. It's so happy touching others. So by that, it got caught. How? There is a female elephant kept in the trap. They wanted to catch hold of the big elephant, of the male elephant. To catch a male elephant, you can't keep a lion. To catch a male elephant, place a trap, which is a female elephant. It will come for the smell of female. It will come for the touch of female. When it comes, the people together will catch hold of the male elephant. So an elephant loses itself. An elephant, it gets defeated because it got carried away by the touch feeling. Don't get carried away by that. Then the next one. Our 14th acharya was Madhuha, a hunter. What did I learn from the hunter? Honey bee collects honey. It was so religious in collecting. It was such a beautiful effort, a collective effort. But after all, when this honey is collected, a hunter enters, kills all the honeybees, takes away all the honey. Who gave him that authority to do? Is it not the property of the honey? Till today, no one has claimed that the honey is the property of the honeybee. Has it ever gone to the court? Is there any problem? I mean, how is this happening? No one is raising his voice that why is that honeybees collect? And why is that we go and take it? We have a right over it. Although the honeybees collect, the hunter has a right. Similarly, a brahmachari cannot earn. Sannyasi cannot earn. But a grihastha can earn. If a grihastha has saved, a sannyasi is rightful. Sannyasi has a right to go request the grihastha to feed him and be fed by him. He has that right. You have, as a grihastha, you have to feed the brahmacharis and the sannyasis. It's a bounden responsibility of the grihastha. We cannot shy away from our responsibility. As a hunter had that right of honey bee and the honey collected. I knew this. Then the 15th one, man, deer. Deer is fond of music. When the deer fells, it falls as a prey to music. The hunter will play a small violin. He plays and the deer is so absorbed in that music, it will stand, it will forget to run away from the hunter will catch hold of the deer. So, don't fall prey to Shabda. That is what I understood from the deer. Then next is Meena. Meena Matsya. What will it fall for? It falls for a bait. There is a small piece of food and it looks at the food. It is so fond of eating. Eating is Rasanubhava. So, the Matsya fish was caught because it was fond of Rasanubhava. I understood that I should not fall prey to Rasanubhava. This is what I knew from the Matsya. Then Pingala. Pingala was a prostitute. She was prostituting, but she always repented that, why am I doing this? Why am I not blessed by Bhagavan? Can I also not reach Shiva Kuntam? She was doing so, but there was a person who was in the opposite house. He was living in the opposite house. He was counting who all entered the house of that prostitute, who all went out of the house of that prostitute, and he went to Naraka. The prostitute reached Vaikuntha. He was there in the opposite house and thinking only of the prostitute. Prostitute was in her house thinking only of Krishna. So both of them let, this is what I came to know. You may even be a prostitute, but yet Bhagavan will bless you and you will get your rightful place. I understood that there. Then the 18th Acharya, Kuraraha. Kuraraha is a bird. Kurara Paravai, bird. That bird had a vada. It has a vada. Masha poopam, guda poopam in its beak. Kurara bird had a vada. All were pressurizing it. They were all compelling. They were around, around. Alva says that, Porulvai undai, Challakkanil, Porti endedvar. If you have money in hand, people just surround you. They come and go. They said that, I am quite close to you. Do you know that we are very intimately related? They may even not be very distantly related, but they would say that we are closely related. But if the moment they know I don't have money in hand, they would say, even my own brother would tell me, I remember I had seen you somewhere. This is the way world behaves. I understood that Kuraraha, when this bird dropped that bada, no one was by the side of the bird. Arbhakaha, Arbhakaha, a boy aged 8. What did he do? He was playing. Suddenly he picked up a quarrel. They quarrel. But next day morning, both parents were quarreling. Because the parents, they wanted to support their children. They started quarreling. That war went on for weeks together. But both the children were quite happily playing from the second day. They were fine. So I understood, mana avamana is for those who want mana avamana. These children do not want mana avamana. What they want is to play. Their objective is to play, not to nurture mana avamana. So let me also not have manam and avamanam. Let someone disrespect or respect. How am I bothered? I came to know that. Then Kumari, a girl who just got married, she had to feed her guests. There were some few guests in her home and she started pounding rice. When she pounded, she had many glass bangles. She was wearing glass bangles. It was creating a lot of noise. So she thought, this is 12 in this hand, 12 in this hand. Let me remove half. Yes, only 6 and 6. The noise reduced, but still it was there. Then again she reduced to 3 and 3. Noise further reduced, but still it was there. He was wearing only 2, reduced it to 2. There was little noise. Then she removed it to 1. There was no noise. Shosi, the Avadhuta Sannyasi, who was sitting in the balcony of this girl, he understood that if there are 2 people, noise. 4 people, more nice. 400 people, very more nice. Alone, no nice. This is what I understood. So, ekantam is very, very important. For you to meditate on Brahman, ekant, ekant, be alone. Krishna says that, aratihi janasamsadi. Janasamsad is asadhu crowd. Crowd of asadhus. Aratihi, one must not be in the companion of people at all. Don't go there, don't waste your time. Be alone, meditate. Hinduism, Sanatana Dharma, is not a congregational Dharma. It is all about individual discipline and meditating alone. We collect together, we don't collect and be good. The good ones collect together. That's the difference in Sanatana Dharma. We don't collect together and behave something good and go back and behave bad. That's not what Sanatana Dharma is. Everyone at home must be good. Alone, I must be a very disciplined person. Discipline is more respected, more valuable than your life itself. That's very important. So, this is the fundamental of Sanatana Dharma. I learnt it. Arbhakaha, Kumari, Sharakrithu, the blacksmith. What he would do? Like this. He has a table like this. He hammers it. He hammers, hammers, hammers and makes a spear, makes a sword, makes a bow, makes an arrow. But when you look at it, one, he is too concentrated. He focuses on one point and keeps on hammering. The iron piece, there will be a big iron piece. On that you keep the other pieces and make it and shape it. This iron piece will never move. It will remain as it is. But it will transform the piece placed on it to be many products. So the piece, the iron piece, will never be disturbed. It will not change. But being unchanged, undisturbed, it will disturb everything else. It will change all that placed on him. Similarly, a yogi will not change. Suppose an offender, a wicked person, comes to a yogi. How would the yogi change? Should the yogi become wicked? The yogi should remain as a yogi and change all the wicked. This is what I understood from a Sharakrit. From a blacksmith, I understood this. Sharakrit, sarpa, sarpam, snake. Sarpam's character is, it will not stay in one place for more than a night. It will change the place. Today was this den, tomorrow is that forest, it keeps moving. Similarly, yogi, a sannyasi, must always be on the move. Do you not say in English? Be on the move. Why should I be on the move? What if I stay in a gramam for 2-3 days? I can, but if I stay under a banyan tree, 2-3 people will visit me. They will ask, Swami, you are a sannyasi. Can you tell me about my fortune? Since he is a yogi, he will tell something and that will be truth. Those people go to the village and say, here is a soothsayer. He is a person who can predict our lives. Oh, villagers, please come, please come. We have a great yogi. They will all come. They will start lamenting about their problems. So this household has this problem, he has this problem, she has this problem. All problems will be the sannyasi, and he will be the biggest grihastha there. He will no more remain to be a sannyasi. He will turn to be a grihastha. So if you had left that place and moved to the next place, you need not get into this trouble. So I learned from the sarpa, snake, that move on, don't stay. If you stay as a sannyasi for more than a day, you invite trouble. Then last, urnanabhihi. Urnanabhi is, I had already given you this example. Urnanadi, the spider, it emits the thread, it builds that cobweb, plays in that cobweb, and when it sees that it's enough, it immediately closes the whole thing, it still sits back, it gulps the whole thing back into it. Similar is Bhagavan as a Jagatkarana. He is the one who creates this world from himself. He transforms and he absorbs everything back onto him. When he says that the game is over, when the game is over, he absorbs everything back on him. So Bhagavan's, that he is the cause of this universe. And how is he a cause? From himself this universe expands, into himself we all get absorbed. I came to know of this from Urnanabhi. Lastly, Supe Shakrit, wasp. It sticks, stinks and stinks. Kotti, kotti, kotti. It changes that worm itself to be a wasp. It will have a worm in its small nest and it keeps on changing, it keeps on sticking that, so that worm itself would change. Similarly, when I have a disciple and he is good, I leave it. When he is bad, I will keep on telling me till he changes to be good. So don't allow anyone to be wicked, to continue to be wicked. I have 24 acharyas to me. I learn every day from all these 24 people. Fine, 24 were over. Yadu Maharaja asked this Avadhuta Sannyasi, it's good that you have 24, but you said you have a more intimate acharya who is the 25th. Who is that? He said, it's my own body. This is my body which teaches me a lot. What does it teach you? It teaches me that I should not have let out myself to this body. I have a house and I have let it out. My house, my tenant has to pay lease rental to me. My tenant has to pay me rent. Neither my tenant pays me rent, nor is he good to me. He is so wicked. He cheats me. No rent, no day. I am unable to do anything, any work on my house. That is what the situation we have in this body. Because we are residing here. We have our eyes, nose, ears, all the panchakarmendriya, jnanendriya. They act as per their wish. They never listen to what we say. So I came to know that if you are letting out to a tenant, first do not let out. Even if you let out, be careful that they conduct as per your wish, not as per their wish. This is what I came to know from the Sharira. This is perishable. This is not eternal. Atman is more important. So this is Avadhuta Upakhyana. Thus Krishna concluded to Uddhava, Uddhava, now you know, you would have understood about detachment, the importance of Vairagya. Are you ready to go to Gandhamadana Parvata? Uddhava said, I am not. You wanted to talk a lot. You wanted not to talk to me. I don't take this as my preaching. I know more than 25 acharyas. You are my 26th acharya. I have no issue. You had told me all these things in Bhagavad Gita. You wanted to convey something to this universe, which you have done. Don't make me a prey for that. I am not here as a soldier. I am not going to get caught in your web. I am here to be with you. Can you now be with me or not? Krishna again started from the beginning. So next, Brahma Mukta, Sadhu Naam Lakshanam. Krishna talked about Sadhu Lakshanam, Sattvic, Rajasic and Tamasic qualities. He also tells about Satsanga Mahima. Oh Sadhu, oh Uddhava, you have to be in the company of Sadhus. Don't worry, don't be in my company. More than mine, Sadhu Sagamagam is important. There is a shloka. Samsara Vishavrikshasya Dvepalehi Amrutopame Kadachit Keshave Bhaktihi Tat Bhaktairva Samagamaha. Here we have many, many trees. All trees in this samsara are poisonous. In these poisonous trees, there are two fruits which are very, very tasty. These two fruits are equivalent to amrita, to elixir. Which are these two fruits? Kadachit Keshave Bhaktihi, Keshava Bhakti, devotion to Lord. Tat Bhaktairva Samagamaha or company of sadhus. Sadhu Samagama. These two are the good fruits.